A sari of blue, and through the front could be guessed her belly's perfection. Like lightning, her beauty flashed upon me through her veils. How shall I describe her? Her glances, ever quick in expression, knew no rest. So many and so pretty were the ornaments she wore that it seemed as if 100 golden bees had settled upon her. As she walked, I saw that her movements were slow as the gliding of a wild swan. Never, in truth, have my eyes beheld lovelier vision. The music of her golden anklets, sounding the fifth note of the scale, was honey sweet. In her own thoughts, she passed by swaying. Such was the entrancing picture that I beheld. When she laughed, nectar drops in hundreds rained down from her eyes. Her waist was slender as a lioness and made me think of the form of the in-tapering tambori drum. Her behind was rounded like a chariot wheel. On her lotus-like feet danced little bells, circling and sparkling about her. Her toes were lacquered and shone far more brightly than the sun. I could not look upon her body. Oh, my friend, tell me, who is this one I know not with the golden skin? I saw her bathing at the water's edge. Listen, O Subala, my confidant, my tender friend, and hear how she looked, this young creature, as she was bathing. By the banks of the Yamuna River, she was sitting cross-legged in the water, upon the blue sari folded under her. Her golden necklace was swinging under her naked breasts that pointed like the tips of the hills of the Sumeru. She loosened her lovely hair, and when she rose after bathing, it rippled all down her back. And darkness, seeing this dusky mass, began weeping and sped away to seek refuge behind the moon. Her bracelets were carved from the seashell and shone like the moon's thin crescent rising in the twilight sky. On the bank of the Yamuna River she walked, wringing my soul with her blue sari. And ever since, peace has quite forsaken my fevered heart.